Cancer, the world itself, gives you a lot of questions and is full of varied emotions. Many people would panic on hearing about cancer. They perceive it as a death warrant and also that it will bring a lot of toxic treatment which will make me worse than what I am today. However, all this is not true. They also worry about self, about family and especially about children. What would happen to them if I am not able to overcome this cancer? And most of the people think that cancer is incurable. Last year brought us a special problem, another calamity in form of COVID-19. Unfortunately, because of the panic created across the country in the minds of people, many of the cancer patients did not seek professional help. They postponed their checkups, their diagnosis, as well as their treatment. Many of those who had symptoms of cancer did not come forward to seek professional help and waited for months together. Even now, today we see patients who have been waiting since the beginning of pandemic and are coming to us now. What has happened is, in waiting for all these months, the cancer has progressed. Something which was curable, which was in stage 1, has progressed to stage 3 or 4 and has become incurable. Something which would have required a very small amount of treatment now requires a lot of treatment and hence its toxic effects also. So as we enter the next phase of the pandemic and the vaccine is on the verge of being launched in our country, I hope things will subside very soon. At the same time, I would like to urge patients having other diseases, especially those having cancer, not to delay seeking help and not to delay their treatment. It is safe to take cancer treatment even with COVID all around. They must understand that most of the patients who get COVID would recover without any problem. But if cancer treatment is delayed for so long, it may kill you. Please do not delay your treatment. Today's time, we see around 15 lakh new cancer patients in our country, most common being breast cancer in ladies and oral cancer in men. And I'll very briefly talk about some changes that we can make in our lifestyle to avoid cancer or to prevent cancer or at least to delay it till a very late age. Because out of these 15 lakh, many people are very young. In fact, patients in our country are almost a decade younger as compared to their Western counterparts. So what can we do? There are certain factors which we can modify, but there are certain which we cannot. So let's talk about the factors which we can change, which we can modify. The most important being your lifestyle. A healthy lifestyle would not only mean healthy eating, but also healthy physical health, mental health, and spiritual health. A proper healthy diet, nutritious diet, full of vegetables, fibers, less of meat, less of oil, fried food, processed food, and junk food. Avoiding any kind of substance abuse like alcohol, tobacco or any other substance will also go a long way in preventing cancer. Tobacco itself is responsible for nearly one-third or even more of the cancers across the world. So we can avoid and prevent a large number of cancers if we can just quit or avoid tobacco completely in our lives. Apart from that, a mental health and your spiritual health also goes a long way to build up your immunity well and prevent cancers. So at the end, I would again urge, continue to take precautions for COVID. Take the vaccine whenever it is available. Please do not delay your cancer diagnosis or treatment and stay healthy, keep a healthy lifestyle and be free of cancer.